Father, for I have sinned. It's been a while since my last confession.
Have you been busy, Matt?
I guess you could say that, Father.
To my trembling lips, how did the night ever get like this? One shot and the whiskey goes down, down, down. Bottom of the bottle hits, waking up my mind as I throw a fit. The breaking is taking me down, down, down. My heart's beating faster, I know what I'm after. Standing here my whole life, everything I've seen twice. Now it's time I realize it's spinning back around now. On this road I'm crawling, save me cause I'm falling. Now I can't seem to breathe right. Whoa, I'm coming alive. Whoa,
sometimes what you want to achieve is not what you want at all. Sometimes you hope you fail.
We are now just receiving information in the case of Jose Casado regarding the murder of Josie Cross. After a 3-day trial, the verdict has come back as not guilty. This shocking result is most likely due to his 2 attorneys. Here speaking now is Franklin Nelson of Nelson & Murdoch.
Well, what can I say? First case, first 2 weeks at the highest rated law school in the country, and winning a case this complex? No big deal. What I want to say is that I do feel sympathy for the family of Miss Cross, and I hope that they eventually find justice. But yet, at the end of the day, the evidence was insufficient, and, well, you know the saying, it's innocent until proven.
Now, Franklin, what have you got to say to your opponents in the case?
Oh, yes. Well, Mom, I bet you're glad I'm not a butcher now.
I was actually referring to the Cross's family attorney.
Oh.
Mr. Murdoch, I had my doubts, but you really did pull through with me in the end.
Well, after all, it shouldn't have been that hard. I mean, after all, you didn't do it. Right, Mr. Consala?
But of course, you're the one who proved it after all, aren't you?
Well, I would say I hope to see you again, but that would mean we'd be back here. But I'll wish you the best of luck anyway.
I want bourbon, I want scotch, I want beer.
First case will be won. That's enough to celebrate. No? Shots?
Muggies, flipping morning. Beer's already stretching a bit.
All those people in law school are going to be so envious. We're headline news. It leans in our favour. You know what this means? More publicity? More clients?
Yeah, the more guilty people they have to lie for.
Why are you being so negative? I thought you'd be happy.
Foggy, why did we decide to settle in Hell's Kitchen? I mean, yeah, it's home, but it's an unfair system here. The legal system in New York needs change, Foggy. I guess I thought we were going to be that change.
Matt, we need to start somewhere. Between me and you, we know he's an asshole. But we did our job to put food on the table and roofs over our heads. The next few years, let's just block out our moral compass and build up our client list, yeah? Enough to make Marcy Stahl choke on her coffee.
Cross said to you?
Didn't you see the news? I'm innocent.
Not in my eyes.
To his girlfriend's house. Good evening, sir.
Why did you kill him?
He thought it was wise to publicize our involvement in Josie Cross's murder.
Then it was a good choice.
We're also having her apartment cleaned of any evidence leading to us.
Any family know of her involvement?
She kept her personal life quiet. We have another problem. That masked vigilante we had to deal with a few months back, he's made something of a comeback.
You know the trouble he caused before.
I know someone who could help.
You have some nerve showing up here. Not my money.
You come to the city of skyscrapers and musicals that you choose to smoke in an alleyway.
Dublin has tall buildings and chimneys. And I'm here to work. But I can't work without a few pulls.
Well, with your price, let's hope you're worth it.
Buddy, it was a take or leave it. I turned down a job for you to seize claw.
Honored we are. Your target is a mass vigilante operating in the Hell's Kitchen.
How do I find him?
He always seems to know where and when we conduct business. He'll find you.
Right, so, over and done with. I'll have time for points after.
Matt Murdock, I presume?
James Wesley.
Matthew Murdock.
I only spoke to Mr. Nelson on the phone. Will he be joining us?
I'm afraid not. Mr. Nelson is currently looking for a new office for the two of us. So he won't be joining us today, unfortunately.
Well, I guess you can take the check off my hands.
Why hire a small law firm that's just out of college?
Well, that's the thing, Mr. Murdock. We're looking for new members of our legal team. Seeing you handle a case that well, we're looking for a fresh face who knows what he's doing.
You know, I was beginning to wonder why you couldn't just handle this payment over mail.
Obviously, this is more of a in-person discussion. We're talking to several candidates for the job. Jerry Hogarth, I'm sure you're familiar with, Desmond Toby, and Marcy Stahl.
Well, I would not bring her up in front of Franklin.
And why is that?
Never mind. Don't worry about it. I'm sorry to hear about Jose. That was terrible.
Tragic bit of news.
Mr. Wesley, Jose was an employee of yours, correct?
An employee of my client.
If you don't mind me asking, do you mind telling me who this client is?
I work with Fisk Enterprises. I manage the relationships between employees and third parties.
And Jose was an employee of yours? Jose told us that he was an independent truck driver.
Well, we only hired him if we were short on drivers, or if we needed to deliver somewhere awkward.
And would you have many other people like this on your roster?
I couldn't give you the exact numbers at this time, but we do often hire locals from the area. Mr. Murdock, you grew up in Hell's Kitchen, yes?
Yes. Before I left for college.
My client grew up here as well. It's not just his part of town. It's his home. He, like everyone else, saw Hell's Kitchen's dark side at a young age. He realized he alone couldn't change it. If we want to make Hell's Kitchen great again, we have to come together and figure this out. Is it the blocks need changing, or it's people? We aren't stopping at Hell's Kitchen. Men in black, web-slingers, the world's changing. But the change be on our terms.
Well, Mr. Wesley, I would have to discuss this with my partner, to be perfectly honest with you, but the odds are not likely. Franklin and myself have wanted to start up Nelson Murdock since Columbia. So I believe that if we're going to fight against the evil in New York, then we'd like to do it as our own law firm.
Well, Mr. Murdock, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't disappointed.
I hope we can work again sometime.
Is the line secure? Good. Tell Bullseye to be stationed at the docks near our warehouse.
Thank you.
sooner or later. You were guarding something in that warehouse. What was it?
I've been confronted by men who, in some cultures, are considered gods.
Well then, I guess that makes me your first demon. Armor-piercing bullets, exoskeletons, the kind of shit criminal organizations need.
Who?
Some of the biggest criminals. Hydra, AIM, the US military.
When do they ship?
In the next couple of hours. In the Fisk distribution warehouse above.
Thank you.
What if I got called from the cops, saying they found you dead in ninja gear?
Foggy, no. Foggy. Foggy. You didn't let me explain. No, there's probably not much to explain. I'm not asking you to agree with what I'm doing.
Not many do. It is a pastime I'm sad to see fade into memory. People could talk for hours about color, brushstrokes, use of the spaces. How many times would you find one of these professional art shows talking about the artist's struggle, his desperation to put colored liquid to a canvas, hoping to make a living and put bread on the table?
Art means different things to different people.
Valid point. However, that was a trick question. This artist is 24 years old, still lives with his parents, claims that his trip to Istanbul inspired him, most likely paid for by his accountant father, who by the way is on the payroll. Hence the problem. I don't see the struggle. Art loses its passion and appreciation. This week changes nothing. We change the plan, but get the same result. I'm coming back to New York this evening. I have not risen from ashes to to lose it all to someone who hides in the shadows. We move on to phase two of our plan.
This is Stan Lee coming at you.
I thought it'd be fun to have a blind superhero, because I had read somewhere when you lose your sight, all your other senses become magnified. So I thought it would be great if we have a guy, even though he can't see, he can do anything better than anyone else. He'd have a radar sense, a sonar sense. He could tell if you're lying, because he could hear your heartbeat change the rhythm. So I loved Daredevil. He became very
the world may change and evolve, but the one thing that will never change is the way we tell our stories of heroism. Those stories have room for everyone, regardless of their race, gender, religion, or color of their skin. The only things we don't have room for are hatred, intolerance, and bigotry. That man next to you, he's your brother. That woman over there, she's your sister. And that kid walking by, hey, who knows? He may have the proportionate strength of a spider. We're all part of one big family, the human family, and we all come together in the body of Marvel. And you, you're part of that family. You're part of the Marvel universe that moves ever upward and onward. Greater glory. In other words, Excelsior.